Hey y'all, welcome back. In the previous video, I had demonstrated this Poudell Spot welder and we all saw it in action. I also talked about its various features and the weld modes that it offers. And today in this video, we are going to look at its mode number 2, which is external relay. So this is the video for those who want a functional spot welder but are a little low on the budget. So today in this video, we are going to make a proper and functional spot welding machine by the use of this cheap selfie starter relay from a motorbike. Before moving any further, make sure to like and subscribe this channel. So without wasting any time, let's get right into the video. So this is the setup that we saw in the previous video. And for today, we will require a power relay. You can get a similar motorbike selfie starter relay for under $4. And if you use this, you won't be needing the power MOSFETs for switching. And the relay that I have in my hand is a starter relay from a 200cc motorbike. We won't be needing its connector, so we can just cut it off. Remove a little bit of insulation and now it is just the matter of connecting the wires to the terminal block. The polarity is written in the backside of the PCB, however, connecting either way is just fine for the type of relay that I am using. Now it is time to switch the negative terminals of the wires from MOSFET bank to the relay. And it is easy using a 10mm range. You can put the battery wire in any copper bolt among two, but just keep in mind that depending upon where you put the battery negative and weld negative, you will need to change the polarity of the power diode, and I will show you how to do that in a minute. After connecting both wires, now it's time to see the real action. But as said earlier, you will need a LiPo battery of minimum 5000 mAh with 60C discharge rating or automotive battery with CCR greater than 500 A. And now you can see, we don't have our screen and it's because it needs external power for welding modes 2 and 3. And as I plugged the external power, it came back to life. So now let's pull up the main menu by double pressing on the rotary encoder and change the welding mode to external relay from battery weld. Now I can go back to the main screen and this should work, right? Well, no, there is a small problem and that is it does not work at all. After tinkering for a bit, I realized that the BC547 BJT transistor that I had used was simply not powerful enough to provide switching current required to activate that relay. It just needs a MOSFET instead of NPN BJT transistor. To solder the MOSFET, we first need to desolder the NPN transistor which was previously soldered on. Soldering iron and a desoldering pump would get the job done just fine. Any MOSFET would work here, but using an SMD one is recommended just because it takes less space. And after the transistor is out, it is just as easy as soldering a MOSFET to it according to the previously sold circuit. And after adding this pull down resistor across the ground and MOSFET gate, the update is done. However, be sure to always check for short circuits in the connections. Now it is just repeating the old process once again. But this time, after stripping the wires, I will tin the ends so that it would be easier to connect the terminal block and the connection would be strong. Now, as said earlier, I will add battery negative lead to one end of the relay and add weld lead to the another terminal. You will also need to add a Schottky diode or FR diode across relay terminals to minimize the sparks inside the relay during the switching, prolong the life of the relay. And now, finally, after tightening the nuts and bolts, I think it is now ready for a test.
And my friends, hear to this. It is not just a sound of a relay switching. It is the sound of a success.
No, listen to this.
So finally, let's do some welding. I will be using this foot switch to activate the welds. And you can see here that if I press the switch, the relay immediately gets closed for a predefined period of time. So far, so good. I will repeat the same weld test as shown in my previous video with 10 millisecond pulse time and single pulse setting and see how good of a weld it makes. The weld sounds strong to me and I think you won't be able to separate that nickel with your bare hands. And even using a plier, it was difficult. This one can weld the nickels with ease. And just to remind you that, this is only 1/20th of the power, so you could surely weld pure 0.2 and 0.3mm nickel strips with this welder. Just to show you, let's do it once again. And this time, the nickel was completely torn apart, so we can say that it was a strong weld. I can assure you that this welder will never let you feel regret and would give you consistently good results.
By the way, if you are interested, then you can actually purchase one of the 15 boards that I have manufactured for the first lot at just $100, and at that price you will get this battery connector, the main PCB pre-assembled, and these welding wires and electrodes. And for a little low money, like for $80, you will get the same board, same battery connector, same wires, but the switching will do the switching will be done by this power relay instead of MOSFETs. This will also work just as well, but this will be a cheaper like $20 cheaper. So please leave a comment if you are interested, or you can directly contact me through the mail or other means. And before ending this video, I would like to thank Mr. Ben Rees, Mohan Karkisar, Mr. Varun Basnet and Bright Future School for your kind support. And thank you all for watching this video till the end. See you all in the next video. Till then, bye bye.